one of these military, well-armed foes seem to hate each other with a passion. In this world where wars are seemingly constant, look at the Middle East right now, we can see that very plainly. But these three factions in particular in this world fight day and night against one another. This war between the factions has been never ceasing and constant. In this world, once again, we see Christ in our text saying that the world itself does not give peace. It does not give anything but that which hurts, that which destroys, that which decays. Christ warns us that we do not put our treasures up where moths decay can happen, but rather we hold our treasure, that is Christ, close to us. Now, these three factions that were fighting against one another all spread from the Garden of Eden. In the Garden of Eden, Eve took the fruit, gave it to her husband, and the war began. The war against God and man had begun. Because this is the reality. When we were in the Garden of Eden, God's will was our will, and our will was God's will. However, when we fell, we all of a sudden gained our own will. And our own will was opposite from God's will. If this is not true, then why do we always pray, "Not my will, but thy will be done"? And so, by nature, sinful and unclean, we fight against God every step of the way. We struggle with Him every step of the way. And yet, God brings us kicking and screaming into the faith. What does Christ say here in our Pentecost text? "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." That which bridges mankind to God and calling for a ceasefire between those two factions is in cruciform way. Christ Himself, He who is crucified, died, buried, and raised up. That ends that war. We are brought into peace. We are brought into the work of the Holy Spirit. And Christ goes away and sends His Holy Spirit. And He says that it is beneficial to us that He does go away, because He will send His Holy Spirit, and His Holy Spirit will work faith in us, will confess our sins, will receive absolution for our deep sins. The Holy Spirit is the one who grows faith, affects faith, and keeps us steadfast in the faith. So when Christ says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you," He is not talking about an emotional peace. He's talking about no longer are we at war with God. Christ has won that battle for us. So what of the third faction? Now that we and God are in a ceasefire, now that peace has been given through Christ, what about the third faction? Christ says, longer talk much with you. For the ruler of this world is coming, and he has no claim on me. Christ Jesus defeated that very wily foe. Satan himself, by the same means that he gave us peace, by the exact same means, Christ crucified, died, and buried, he crushed the head of the serpent. He won against Satan, and his victory is our victory. So, when we come and we deal with one another in a world that seems to despise us, be like Jesus. Be like the Holy Spirit. Forgive quickly. Love passionately. Do not let the sun go down in your anger. Let the Holy Spirit work in you, because his work is a true work of love, and of peace, and of faith. And truly, we cannot live in this world without the Holy Spirit. He guides us. He governs us. He is the lamp to our feet, light on our path. When we are baptized into the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And in this very font, the Holy Spirit enters into mankind. And then, peace is left between man and God. And for that child, Satan is gone. Victory won. So, here we have one of my favorite texts in verse 31. Rise, let us go from here. Christ had said all that he needed to say about the Holy Spirit, and then he says, rise, let us go from here. And we too need to hear those words and rise and go from here. One of the most amazing things is when we commune on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we become tabernacles, going into the world carrying Christ's own body and blood.